All right, our handsome men debate continues. Weighing in now, the beautiful Wendy Malick, who doing the ranch opposite Sam Elliott. We told you that James Brolin was here.
Yes, you did. Please. Another handsome old fox.
Please, Celeste. do these men get better looking?
Oh, it's so annoying. some of them do. Some of them do. You know, I think one of the secrets is hair.
Okay.
If they keep a good mane and it turns silver and, you know, they take care of themselves, they can just keep on rocking it.
All right.
But so can women.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, we can hang in.
Wendy, and it's funny because Henry's like, he just has that bit of rugged. And I said, it's too bad you can't say that about women when we get older. She's got that touch of rugged.
But there is that phrase that she's very handsome looking.
She's a handsome.
They used to say that. Or classic looking.
Right. But they used to say that about Lauren Bacall. That Lauren Bacall is the most handsome woman imaginable.
Katherine Hepburn.
That's exactly right. Yeah. All right, Wendy, we see you here on the lot. You know, now they're shooting all these shows here because of Netflix. Ashton Kutcher show, The Ranch is here, and I literally every time I drive out of here, I see you having lunch.
Yeah, you know, I joined their cast this season, and I get to be the most successful lady rancher in the state.
Oh wow!
Yeah, I'm the big cheese.
Oh good!
I drive a big old honking truck, and I actually have to drive it onto the set. I can't believe they let me do that. I sometimes miss my mark and have to do it over. But it's fun, and they're a lovely group. And Ashton and Sam, I have most of my stuff is with them, and I've always been a huge fan of theirs, and always, particularly of Sam's. He's just, he's as kind and lovely as you could imagine, and just got the best voice,
I know.
I think.
Sam Elliott, as you know, has got the deepest, most robust voice. Have you ever been tempted to have him do the voice on your phone
machine? I've been tempted to buy a Dodge Ram just because
he likes it. Yeah. Let me ask you this, because everybody who's been on a successful show, and you've been on several, but every show that has run for any length of time is now being rebooted. If they said, oh, let's do Just Shoot Me Again, are you in or are you
out? You know what? We are so crazy about each other. We still have dinner like 3 or 4 times a year together, the whole cast. And recently we said, maybe we should come back and do this again. I mean, it is like wrangling cats, kind of. You have to get everybody when they're free, and it's a little tricky. And same thing with Hot in Cleveland. There was some talk about bringing that back, but I think if you're going to do that, you want to make sure that you have the best writers and make it as wonderful as it was, or otherwise you're just, you're kind of peeing on something. Though that's a terrible phrase.
Spinning your wheels.
You're spinning your wheels. Right. Yeah, you're not honoring the thing that you did that you loved so much.
Let's talk about this. Darrow and Darrow in the Key of Murder. These Hallmark movies are fun.
These Hallmark movies are very fun, and we get to shoot them in Vancouver, and I love that town. Beautiful. Love it. This one is the second one, and Kim Williams Paisley plays my, she's the lead and is my daughter in this, and we're both attorneys, and we have a third generation, my granddaughter, played by Lila Fitzgerald, who's a lovely young actress, and it's really fun. Tom Cavanaugh is her love interest. We have a rather dicey relationship, my daughter and I. Conflict.
Right. But you know what, you tell me, because with the Hallmark things, it doesn't get too, you know, you don't see, it's not blood and gore, it doesn't get too heavy in the drama?
No, it you can go to sleep and not have bad dreams if you watch the things. But there is some tension there, but also a lot of humor.
There we go. Yeah. Darrow and Darrow in the Key of Murder premieres Sunday, May 6th, this Sunday, on Hallmark's Movies and Mysteries. Wendy, you're just around the corner. Come by anytime.
Why, thank you.
Okay, very good. See you again.
Good to see you, Wendy.